everyone, my name is Gabby, and I'm going to be live reacting to Team Four Stars Dragon Ball Z Abridged Episode 60, Part 1. It's kind of hard to believe, really. Like, I and a lot of people who are big fans of Dragon Ball Z Abridged, like, you know, we've been thinking about this episode and waiting for this episode for months and months, and like literally actually over a year, and we've been technically thinking about when this episode was going to come out for probably more than a year, for a very long time. And now it's actually here. It almost just kind of felt like it snuck up on us. It kind of came completely out of the blue. I know that like a few years ago when I was still like really kind of really hardcore into sort of following everything Dragon Ball Z Abridged related, I almost kind of thought that when an episode like this was going to come out, it was just going to like change everything, be like a like life-changing experience, just blow everybody away. But in reality, I don't know if everybody could really keep their hype up that high for over a year. But at the same time, I think that's actually okay. I could do a whole big self-reflection because doing reactions to Dragon Ball Z Abridged was how I started this YouTube channel in the first place. And, you know, it could be a kind of almost like, you know, everything coming completely full circle. But I don't know if that's really necessarily appropriate. I mean, if people just want to see my reaction, I want to see my reaction. This episode has come out and I want to watch it and I want to see what is happening. So maybe we'll just skip the preamble, go straight to the things that I'm specifically looking forward to. So then, as for things that I'm looking forward to in this episode, or at the very least the first part of this episode, that this is the beginning of the Gohan Cell fight for proper. Because I know that a lot of people kind of associate this fight and they like about this fight, this one part where Gohan punches people really hard, and like that's kind of like the thing that everyone remembers. But like, in all honesty, like this part, the part that they're going to be covering now, is the part that I'm like legitimately I find really really fascinating, because it's basically like that this fight is basically all like entirely kind of character driven. Like the way that the events unfold of the story, the way that the fight unfolds, is basically entirely driven by the different characters in the story and their personalities and like, you know, their needs and their wants and how they kind of conflict with each other. And there is actual conflict. Like there is legitimate character conflict, to the point that you could say that like the Gohan Cell fight at the very least starts off as like a kind of almost like character study of all of the main characters in Dragon Ball. And considering one thing that I've really kind of praised Team Four Star for being able to do really well throughout their time doing this Abridged series was like, you know, character interactions and stuff like that, you know, I kind of feel like this is like a part of the story that they could really make really interesting and legitimately fun to watch. Like, even without just, you know, having jokes in it, even without just being like, you know, incredibly jokey and yada yada yada, like, I think it's like a part of the series that I legitimately would want to kind of be seen in a slightly different way, or, you know, with slightly different words or a slightly different tone. Like, I find it legitimately interesting, so I'm really interested to see Team Four Star handle it. And the other thing that I'm especially looking forward to, and I'm legitimately curious about, is how they're going to handle essentially like the really big moment of the Gohan Cell fight. I mean, pretty much everyone who's seen the Gohan Cell fight probably knows what I'm talking about. It's like the big Gohan moment, and it's also in the Japanese version as well. There is a very specific piece of music that plays in it, and the fact that that piece of music does play in it is, I think, one of the reasons that makes that moment so kind of special when you're watching it in the series, like especially when you're watching the Japanese version. So, you know, I'm about like 95% sure that they are putting some version of that musical track into that part, that moment when they played in the Abridged series, but I don't exactly know how it's going to work or what they're going to do with it or how long the piece of track's going to be, you know. But, you know, like, big, like, fancy insert songs get me really hype all the time, and Team Four Stars has done this before. The only thing that I'm a little bit almost kind of concerned about is that, you know, when I was talking about how this is almost like a kind of big sort of character study, so obviously there are character moments for like Gohan and Cell and for some other characters, but there are also some character moments for Goku. And I'm actually legitimately wondering how Team Four Star is going to handle that kind of aspect of Goku and everything like that. Because the fact is, like, they've been playing very hard on the kind of, like, the joke is that Goku is a bad dad kind of thing. And that sort of led to, like, at the very least, Gohan having quite a bit of resentment. And I do wonder if there's going to be some kind of, like, climax to that, some kind of payoff to that, or if it's just going to be, like, that's just, like, a random aspect of Goku's character, and it's not, like, all leading to a specific moment in the plot. Because in the original story, Gohan has no issues. No one really has any issues with Goku being a bad dad. So I don't necessarily know how they're going to handle it, and I hope it's just not a bit too mean-spirited, because there are points later on in the fight where it's kind of really important that we do kind of care about Goku and don't think that like he's a horrible person. So yeah, I legitimately am wondering what they're going to do, and I'm just still so looking forward to this. In all honesty, the Gohan Cell fight and the stuff that's probably covered in this episode were parts of the story that I think honestly kind of mean a lot to me, and when I first watched them, and they kind of mean a lot to me now as well, basically because of that. They're kind of indirectly sort of perhaps maybe the reason why I'm sort of here today, the person that I am. And that sounds kind of a little bit crazy and shocking, but in a way that's kind of the case. If I do something weird and stupid, like start crying, maybe that's why. I know it's almost like, you know, I'm making it sound like it's like the beginning of a new world or something, when it's just an episode of a parody series. But like, for somebody who has been following this pretty religiously for like over 3 years and has been doing stuff on YouTube because of it and has, you know, gone to America because of it, like, this stuff's kind of important for me. I guess for some people, this might just be just a reaction. For me, it's like almost like a giant self-reflection. And also a reaction. And also a fun, like, Dragon Ball Z comedy parody series. So yeah, I might as well stop beating around the bush and actually get started. In 3, 2, 1.
The following is a fan-based parody. Dragon Ball, Dragon Ball Z, Dragon Ball GT, and Dragon Ball Super are all owned by Funimation, Toei Animation, Shueisha, and Akira Toriyama. Please support the official release.
Folks at home, we here at CTV do not condone child violence. We will, however,
continue to bring
it to you live in high definition, all thanks to our sponsors at Heatap. When you're feeling zapped, bring the tap.
Goku.
Don't worry, Piccolo. At some point, Cell's hand is going to cramp up. And then Gohan will... Oh, God, me! Gohan!
You're quite a treat to knock around, kid. Durable like your father, but soft like your mother. What if you think the only way to win is to not play? I have news for you, brat. You're playing the wrong game. Gohan, die!
You must be so proud.
Your precious runt is becoming a man.
Yeah, but... I mean, it could be dodging better.
Gravy! This 11-year-old child is currently fighting for his life!
How does he know he's 11?
He thinks the Make-A-Wish Foundation has gone too far this time.
Oh, that's messed
Game
up.
Game over, kid.
That has got a hat. Probably.
Dear sweet merciful God, I think he's dead!
Can we show that on network television? We're live, so...
Sweetheart, remember, you have another one coming!
Oh, God!
Chala! Hechala! Ega utora seto de Kyo mo ai 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 ai
Sparking! God damn it, it's here! Let's do this thing! Oh, jeez.
So, which one of you wants to try and describe the word filicide to Goku? I'd ask Gohan, but... Well, he's been filicided.
I'm actually not sure what it means either.
That's when you murder a pony?
It means Gohan is dead! And it's your fault, Goku! He's dead!
Wait, is that...
Gohan! Stop hiding your power level and come on out, you goof!
Oh, goody.
Go on. You can do it. Actually, you're not gonna do
can
it.
Can I say something?
Yes.
I've been humoring you this entire time anyway, so why not?
I know this series too well.
But if you're looking to exchange bobs, I'd recommend cutting your teeth on something simpler first. Like that embarrassment over there.
Leave me out of this!
I know why I'm here. I know why my dad threw me to the biggest wolf in the woods.
Oh, trust me.
Oh, this is why I love him.
Puff and blow you down.
He's 11.
I'm 6.
It's because whenever I get backed into a corner, I snap. And when I do, I hurt people.
Real life.
How edgy.
What do you do to them?
When I get angry, when I lose my mind, my power skyrockets and everything goes red. The world around me just fades away. And all I can see is the person I want to kill. Of course, I've never actually managed to beat anyone in the past, but I think my dad knows that if I snap here...
Let me guess.
You'll kill me?
You said it, not me.
God, he's so, like, cynical about it all.
Well, threaten me with a good time.
Huh?
At first you had my curiosity, but now you have my erection.
God damn it!
You all know what I'm about.
God damn it!
That's Freeza's move! The one he killed Vegeta with! Remember that, Vegeta?
It's there.
You should really watch out for that.
Didn't Frieza blow you up?
Oh, yeah!
Then you should really watch out for that!
That's you.
Blue Star?
No.
What's that? Is that a club? Can I join?
No!
Aww!
So to be clear, when you break, I die. Is that the gist of it?
That would be the process of events, yes.
Well then, let's see which breaks first.
Just according to cake.
Endless pile of hay, Goku. This is the last straw.
God damn it.
If you don't go out there, your son, your flesh and blood will die. No ifs, ands, or buts.
But...
No buts!
Speaking of butts, which way do you think his organs are gonna come out? Because I'm betting mouth, but I'm hoping.
I get what you're saying, but this is exactly what I've been planning out this whole time.
You? What could you possibly?
Why do you think Gohan and I went into the time chamber after Vegeta and Trunks?
Ego?
Because if Gohan and I came out first, we'd have killed Cell right away. But we didn't have job to Vegeta? Well, I mean, you saw what happened.
I'm confused because it sounds like you knew Vegeta would screw up.
It was gonna be him or Krillin.
Oh my god. But how did you know he wouldn't just kill everyone after becoming perfect?
I took care of that myself. Oh, and Cell? You're gonna die.
Oh my god, this is so smart!
I'd never pass that up. Because I wouldn't.
Okay, but why Gohan?
Fucking good!
Piccolo, I ain't gonna be around forever. Sooner or later, that's just gonna stick, you know? So what then? Someone's gonna be here when I'm not. And when I was in the chamber with him, I realized that that person is Gohan.
Listen to those bones crackling and
so, falling. Oh, I love it.
So where's the snap, kiddo?
They're good head cannons.
Like father, like son. Wait, no. Oh. Like father, like son, Gohan.
God damn it, that's bad puns. That's not a perfect pun, that's a bad
like
pun.
I thought of almost everything.
I just treated it like one big fight. Kind of like everything in my life.
Unfortunately, you skipped one small detail.
What's that?
Gohan doesn't like fighting, you moron!
What? No. I mean, right?
Have you ever, in your life, actually asked your son what he likes?
But he went in that chamber with me for that whole year.
Because he wanted to spend time with you, his father, the man who spends half his time training and the other half dead, sometimes both.
I mean, is anyone else?
Yeah,
I mean,
a little bit.
Pretty hard to dispute.
And that was perfect.
I've made a terrible mistake.
No,
yes!
A terrible mistake, that's you.
Krillin, I need another Senzu Bean.
Oh, no way, Goze!
Krillin, I'm serious! You're gonna use it on me this time!
Krillin, I'm serious! I'm gonna use it on me this time!
Oh, this is so good!
Just quick update, everyone. These are now tournament illegal. Alright, thank you.
Okay, that's my
Oh
bee.
My god, the sonic right, sound effect. Krillin,
this is everybody's bee.
I have done literally nothing wrong.
Yeah, join the club.
So there is a club.
I see now that not all roads lead to Rome. Torture won't do the trick, so let's change up the game plan, shall we? I'm going to drag each one of them down here and murder them until you finally give me what I want.
No, please!
Shh, it's okay. I'll save your dad for last.
Oh!
Piccolo!
I mean, if you're just gonna say it.
I don't get it. Stay away from me!
That condescension is so
Sit
good!
Down.
Like...
This might take a while.
Oh! Oh! So...
Listen,
so good!
Buddy, I'm thrilled that you're finally coming around to me, but your timing is less than ideal!
Everybody's getting love today, folks!
They're doing... They're nailing it! They're nailing it!
Stop calling him that!
Don't judge our rope romance!
What is he doing?
Within me is a high-yield nuclear explosive. I am going to self-destruct and take Cell with me. Also, probably most of you. That is my B.
I do not consent to this!
Your compliance isn't a factor.
You had a chunk of your head missing. How do you remember that?
Wait! You don't have to do this, Brobot! You still have so much to live for!
If I do not do this, Cell will continue to kill and destroy. Also, I call dibs. I cannot kill Goku. Nobody will kill Goku.
We can split him 16 in half together.
Wow.
You cannot talk your way out of this one, Cell. My countdown has started. 10.
What are the odds of outrunning a nuclear 9. Explosion?
Find me a bomb 8. Shelter. No, a fridge.
You're being 7. Really selfish right now. I hope you 6. Know that.
Larry, one more 5. Time. For old time's sake.
Where there's smoke, there's firecracker, sir.
God damn right.
1. No. 0.
Oh, I like the fake outs. Good.
-1. -2. -. A critical error has occurred. Where's the kaboom? There was supposed to be a cell-shattering kaboom.
Oh, right. My mom said she took out your bomb during repairs.
Who gave her the right?
Well, 16, not that this long embrace hasn't been heartwarming at all. My endorphins are just going crazy right now. But I have a child to break. Now, if I'm correct, you were looking for a kaboom?
If I said no, would you still...
No!
Oh, 16.
If I knew he was gonna go nuclear on Cell, I'd have left the stupid thing in him!
Why'd you even take it out in the first place?
Are you joking? Imagine if he decided to blow his payload the first time he saw Goku! Try explaining that to Chi-Chi. Whoops!
And that makes
sorry
sense.
I let your husband and child get nuked! But the Hippocratic Oath and all that.
Bulma, I think you need to relax more. How's about a brewski?
I'm still breastfeeding.
Well, then two of us are thirsty.
Oh, goddammit.
You go, baby.
Oh, 16, I wanted you to be the wind beneath my wings. But all you've done is take the wind out of my sails. Now I don't even feel like killing these fools.
Does that mean?
Yes, kiddo, I'm not going to kill your daddies.
Technically.
They are.
That works as well.
Implication being...
Oh my god.
Ladies and gentlemen at home, the terrible Cell is now... doing one of two things. I'm pretty sure we can't show either on network television.
I don't understand. Where's the egg? You did this to me!
Life finds a way
to make me vomit!
Huh, this seems easy. I don't get what Chi-Chi was complaining about.
Oh, fantastic. That's gonna be doing that the rest of the day. Goku, I've decided that your insistence on fighting your progeny will be best returned in kind. So behold,
what are they gonna do with them?
Children, Norio, Damien, Travis, Curtis, Dale, and Jonathan.
Are they like Cell voices? Because I know
Vegeta
Damien is.
Junior.
Oh my! Is that gonna be the extra one?
Every nightmare I've ever had fused into one, cloned itself, the clone, and then made those.
That is. Terrifyingly accurate.
Gather round, children. Daddy set up a playdate.
Wait, what?
For
are they
you.
Napper's voices
now
or something?
Make sure you share your toys. Don't leave Daddy's sight.
You can't really.
And bring me the bodies. But most
it's a bit hard to tell when they're all like talking at once.
Cell Junior's incoming!
We're not calling them that!
Okay, it is.
I'm fighting you.
Okay, so they're like, they're Nappa. Okay.
Are they not precious, my own little family? Now,
and they're just
I'm
as annoying.
With this worthless little planet, I'll have someone to accompany me as I trounce about the stars. Perhaps I'll try conquering Namek. Wear that hat for a little while.
No.
Yeah, you're right. That's the Frieza talking.
So, where does this fit into your master plan?
Well, you know what they say. Everyone has a plan until they get punched in the...
Please! I take back what I said about my hidden power! I don't want to fight you! This is my dad's fight, not mine! So I'm begging you, just rein them in! Give my dad a Senzu bean and...
And there it is! That right there.
That is why I despise you. You know what they all have in common? The Saiyans might be fools, the humans might
fucking
be weak, and the Namekian might not believe.
Character interactions, I love it!
But they're still out there fighting. Not just for their lives, but for this dunghill of a world. See, even Krillin's doing his best.
Thanks for noticing! I really try!
Krillin!
But none of them, boy. Not a one shares that trait with you so vile it drives me to wretch.
Pacifism?
Gohan, you're a coward.
No! I'm just a pacifist!
So,
oh, there we go!
Patting himself on the back. Congratulations, pint-sized. You can stand proud next to the bodies.
Yeah! Please don't break my
so
arm!
So good! They're actually talking about this! About what this means! Which with the original series didn't!
Dear viewers, it looks like Sonic
got full
Septimom with seven sinister spawns! Mr. Satan, do you have a plan to deal with these terrifying toddlers? These chilling
children,
these...
And we haven't even gotten to the... to Umanohi yet.
Predators!
Spoilers.
You see, Jimmy, those aren't actually children. They're dwarves, paid to fight on his behalf. I'm gonna go right now and look up their agents and give them a piece of mind.
Excuse me.
Yes?
I seem to be without a body. Yes. Would you mind lending me yours? Why are you screaming?
Because you're a talking head!
So are you.
That is cutting, sir.
I need one of you to give me a hand. I must get close to Cell and the boy, so one of you will need to get me there. I believe that I know a way to finally put an end to this madness.
Are you crazy?
By talking to people.
What makes you think we're going anywhere near that war zone?
I'll do it.
Mr. Satan?
I have a daughter at home, Jimmy. Little girl about the age of that boy out there. Right now, I'm being told I might be able to save the world. And all I gotta do is throw this robot's head in spitting distance of that crazy killer bug monster? Sure. That may sound crazy.
No, it's definitely crazy. Larry?
I have been finding God throughout this entire experience.
Well then, who better to leave it to than the world martial arts champ, Mr. Satan? And besides, what did I tell you, Jimmy? It's all a bunch of tricks.
They are not. You could die.
Do you have a mute button or something?
Not anymore.
Damien sure is kicking the shit out of Yamcha. It's like a metaphor. He honestly doesn't deserve this. But it's still funny.
Hey!
Hmm?
I'm gonna whip off your head and,
Yeah, come on, you can do it. I believe in you.
It's like he doesn't want to. He doesn't want to do it, but then Cell's just like, just do it.
Lunch.
Now you're just embarrassing us both.
Seriously, like, it's really traumatizing.
How hard is it to piss off an 11-year-old? You should be a stopping mess for me taking a toy away. Meanwhile, your friends and family are getting beaten into mulch, and all you can do is cry? And now he's crying? Are you serious? Maxie,
so
kids, put your toys away. We're going home.
Sorry.
Wait!
And to be clear, I mean kill them all, so I can blow up this shithole and find something better to do. Waste of my f***ing Sunday.
Hold on! I'm just one step closer to the edge, and I'm about to—
Everything you say to me is pissing me off. You had your chance, kid, and in the end, it didn't even matter.
Wait!
Ow, ow, ow. Let's go. Let's do this. Let's do this thing.
Thank you for your assistance.
Don't name me,
Mr. Satan.
Kids, when you're done with them, draw and quarter that buffoon. As for you, I'm surprised you're still... Well, I was going to say kicking, but...
Gohan.
Huh?
All right, fine. Then you talk to him, Jesus.
What are you...
Grow up.
Huh?
You act like you are the only one suffering. But I believe that Trunks has some stories for you, and I can assume they all end with, and then he died too. And before you start whining about your father, again, and I get it, take a moment to consider that my father made me a soulless killing machine to kill your father. And that doesn't even come close to the complete tragedy of fatherhood that is Vegeta.
You wanna come up here and say that?
I am ahead.
Then maybe you should quit while you are.
Cell was right. You think you're better than everyone else, but there you stand. The good man doing nothing. And while evil triumphs and your rigid pacifism crumbles into blood-stained dust, the only victory afforded to you is that you stuck true to your guns. You were a coward to your last whimper. Of fear and love, I fear not that I will die, but that all I have come to love, the birds,
this
and
actually,
the things that are not birds,
this is good.
Will perish with me.
It's different, but it's good.
So
I like
please,
it.
So please, Gohan, stop holding back. And hey, if we do make it out of this, please pick up my head and beat your father to death with...
Let's go. Let's do it. Come on. Got 2 minutes. We've got 2 minutes?
I'd say he's gone to a better place, but we both know he never had a soul.
Oh my god, it's a fucking remix! Yes! Just means I can't start singing along in Japanese. But yeah, let's hear it. Let's do this. Let's go!
Feel it getting closer. Revealing such a machine.
Go on.
Turning point of destiny. Right now it's your time. My life is on the line and I will not flee. By my power.
Whoa, whoa.
It's clear to me. My spirit grows and I will face this demon.
Oh my god. Continue part 2. What's that? Oh my god, if they bring back the song for like part 2 or part 3. Oh my god, because I think that, Oh great! I only have another song to like memorize in my head. Oh jeez. I think I did start crying! Woo! Okay, no, that's not the first thing that should really come out for it, but I was like, legitimately, I was always just wondering, like, am I gonna see this and then it's gonna make me start crying? And then I guess I did. And oh god damn it. God damn it. That was so, like, it did everything. Everything that I wanted it to do. Like, the character interactions, they were there. Pretty much all the ones that I liked and the ones that I didn't even think about. This is definitely something that is not in the original, not really, but I'm still okay with it. What Cell was playing at in this thing, what seems to be the thing with this thing, is just like, Gohan's being like, no, I don't want to fight you because I'm a pacifist. And then Cell's interpretation of that, and 16's interpretation of that was basically just like, that's basically saying, you're not a pacifist, you're being a coward. You don't want to stand up for yourself. And it actually works. It actually works because, like, that was his character arc. At the beginning of the series, stop being a crybaby and learn how to grow up. And they're saying that that's still a factor. God damn it, this is so good. I hope I'm not like, you know, going completely crazy over reaction here, but it's so good. And then like Goku realizing, once again, it's different from canon, but it's fine and it's really good and I like it. It's like Goku's issue was he spends the entire time realizing that Gohan doesn't want to do this. He'll do it if he has to, but like, he doesn't want to. If he has the choice, he'd rather not. And because he doesn't want to fight, that's why he's not really giving it his all, fighting Cell, even though Cell's gonna blow up the planet. It captured it all. It didn't make characters look like they were, like, crappy people or, like, you know, like, really different to canon. It's like, they completely chewed out Gohan there, and I was completely fine about it, even though he's my favorite character, and I love the Glavius personality. I like it. I like all of this. I think it's great. I'd say this is worth the 3 years. At the very least, it was definitely the thing that I wanted it to be. And obviously, like, when you're, like, a fan of Dragon Ball Z Abridged, you know, you say, oh, you want them to do this joke, and you want them to do this like this. And it's like, okay, great, whatever, sure, great, that's fine. But, like, and it's almost, like, a little bit, like, demanding. Like, it's a bit demanding. You say, you know, like, you want this parody series to do this joke like this. But, like, Heroes, like, you know, I wanted them to do things, make it interesting, and they did. And they did it interesting. And I like it. God, it's like actually making me rethink. Making me rethink Gohan versus Cell. And I've rethought Gohan versus Cell, like, 5 million times in my years of watching Dragon Ball. Now I need to think about next episode. Because, like, see, now I'm just thinking about the themes of this parody series. And then the themes of this parody series. So it's like, you know, if Gohan has to kind of sort of, you know, grow up, learn to, like, you know, not necessarily get over being a pacifist, so that's kind of essentially what it is. It's sort of like, you know, learning to grow up and learning to learn how to fight and stuff. The fact is, Gohan's attitude in the next few parts of the story kind of have consequences. So I kind of wonder if there's almost going to be some kind of reconciliation or something. Like, Gohan got over his pacifism the wrong way, and then he's going to, like, figure out the right way to do things, and maybe that's going to have something to do with Goku? I don't know. I'm just, like, thinking about it, like, looking at Dragon Ball Z, like, it's an in-depth character analysis, but to be honest, that's kind of what the Cell Saga is a lot of the time, and that's why I love it. Oh, God. I think that's pretty much all I can really say. It's all that's really in my mind now from the first time I watched it. I'm so glad. I'm so glad they did all that. Thank you, everyone. Thank you for making one of my favorite parts of the series a thing that I still like, even when you're making fun of it. This is Gabby signing out, and I guess, well, I'll see you next week for part 2, I guess, because I think part 2 is coming out next week. So, yeah. Bye, guys!